Dad, there. Myrtle says no one can outshine this bride.
Hey, I am having my tailor sew mirrors on my cummerbund as we speak.
Don't you dare. Now, come on, did you decide on the cake?
Definitely chocolate, chocolate.
It has to have white frosting, Trevor.
Wah! Timmy will ditto me on that. White tastes like cardboard.
What about peach?
Peach? And chocolate? Forget about the cake and leave cake.
Stop it. You have to leave. You have to leave.
Vertical, forgive me if I'm a little bit late.
Yes, but I won't. Look, Myrtle's coming over with my wedding outfit, and you cannot be here.
I don't want to see you in a dress. I want to see you out of it.
Just a minute. Yes? Oh, I didn't have any luck. Did you?
I'm afraid not.
I'm so sorry.
Well, we'll find it later. Now, right now, I want you to forget about the cameo.
Yeah, but I wanted to wear it tonight.
Yeah, but you look absolutely beautiful just the way you are. And perhaps it's best that you don't wear it tonight. Natalie, tonight is about the future, our future. And that brooch is, well, it's part of the past.
You're just trying to make me feel better.
Well, am I succeeding?
Kiss me, and I will tell you. Yes, you're succeeding.
Come on, we have to get downstairs and greet our guests. Ready?
Asking for my approval?
In a way, yeah.
Well, I think it's great that you and Mom are hitting it off. I mean, why wouldn't I?
I just thought that maybe you...
That maybe I'd be against it because you're white, right?
Listen, Terrence, after what you've been through, I'd understand if you felt that way.
Look, my mom raised me better than that. I mean, I grew up with prejudice, but we all do. But she told me that each person is an individual, that good and bad people come in all shapes, sizes, and races. She told me, be proud of my black heritage, but don't choose my friends because of their skin color.
She's a wise woman, your mother.
Yeah. But she can also be stubborn and difficult, too.
Yeah, well, I think we can all be stubborn and difficult from time to time.
Yeah, well, listen, with you occupying her time now, maybe she won't spend so much time worrying about me, you know?
I don't know. I think Livia's always going to find time for that.
Yeah.
It's just because she loves you so much.
I know. As much as I gripe about her, I love her just as much.
Your son is going on 18 years old.
I know.
In all those years, we haven't heard one word from you. Not one word. And now you want to drop out of the sky and meet him? Who do you think you are?
I'm his father.
His? Ugh! How could you even utter that word?
Look, I don't blame you for being angry with me. But I have thought about you.
Oh.
I've thought about you a lot.
Oh! Well, not enough to write. Not enough to pick up a phone.
I didn't know where you were.
Well, I think you could have found us because we've actually been using our real names.
Livia, I'm here now, and I want to meet him. And I thought that he might want to meet me, too.
Why? So he could thank you for all those years of ignoring him? What's really going on here, Lucas? Huh?
I haven't been home in a long time. And I heard that you and Terrence moved here and were living with Derek. And I was in the area.
So you thought you'd drop by for a cup of coffee?
I want to see him, Libby.
You can't. He's not here.
Look, this isn't a good time. I mean, you're all dressed up ready to go out. Just tell me, is he okay?
He's fine. And that's really all you need to know.
I'm not going to try and defend my walking out. But I have some reasons.
18 years of them, apparently.
Maybe we can sit down and talk sometime.
Talk? I don't have anything to say to you, and you don't have a damn thing to say to me. There's one thing. Terrence and I have a very good relationship. It's very strong, it's very special, and we struggled a long time with no help from you, but we made it. We made it, and there's no room for you. So why don't you crawl back under that rock you've been hiding under and keep pretending you can't find us?
I can't do that.
I want you to stay away from me and my son!
Mr. and Mrs. Jeremy Hunter! Miss Haley Vaughan and Mr. William Cortland.
Did you know about this?
No.
Where did he get the nerve to show up here?
If he does anything to hurt you...
No, don't worry about it. I can't figure out why he's been invited.
Well, he's one of the enchantment's employees, and I heard that they were all invited.
Oh, so that's it.
Yeah, well, just look around. A lot of these folks work for enchantments. Mm-hmm.
And he's courting.
Courting?
Yes. Oh, you haven't heard. He's attempting a takeover of Erica's business.
Poor Erica.
Oh, don't use poor and Erica together. Believe me, if I'd say poor Dimitri.
Well, Merrick's no slouch. He's a force to be contended
with. Oh, poo. He's just a puny little... Oh.
Mr. and Mrs. Adam Chandler. Oh.
Too bad she had to ruin it with that clown on her arm.
Well.
Joan, my goodness, don't you look beautiful?
Thank you. Well, I thought I did till you showed up.
Oh, don't be silly. Thank you. You look great.
Haley,
oh, aren't you wonderful?
Oh, thank you. Boy, you are the star of this ballroom gown.
Oh, thank you. It is pretty incredible, isn't it?
Yes. Hello, Will.
Hello, Erica. Haley's right. You're breathtaking.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you all. Oh, my goodness. I can't tell you how wonderful I feel about your reception and how much it means to me to know that my people are behind me.
Oh, we love you, boss.
I hope you're getting this. Excuse me, Erica.
Yes, well, indeed, darling. Hello.
My boss would slay me if I didn't get a comment from you. Just a quick question. That was quite a stirring moment when you entered. How does it feel to be adored by your staff?
It feels wonderful, of course. Enchantment is such a close-knit company. I feel that all my employees are really family. Naturally, this outpouring of affection for me is just... Well, it's quite incredible. It makes me feel just fantastic. I can't express it in words to you. And, of course, their support for me has always meant a great deal, but never more than right now.
Oh, you're referring, of course, to
after that show of solidarity, I believe that Mr. Merrick would be very well advised to give up. After all, so many of my employees are now shareholders. And I think that they have made it very clear that they are exceedingly satisfied with present management. Don't you?
Then you don't feel that Mr. Merrick's takeover threat is really serious?
Oh, I believe it. Merrick's takeover threat is quite serious. Just misguided.
If you'll excuse us, Lady, I think we should say hello to our hosts.
Absolutely. Good luck to you.
Thank you so much, Dee.
Thank you. And Bud.
Thank you.
Dimitri. Oh. Natalie, what a glorious evening.
Yes, isn't it?
So glad of you to join us.
Oh, I wouldn't have missed it.
Natalie, you look marvelous.
Yes, they both.
Well, thank you so much. I'd say that your festive occasion really brings out the best.
Well, your employees seem very devoted.
Yes, that is not an illusion. They do adore me.
Well, my hat is off to anyone who inspires such loyalty in their employees.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. Oh, I'd say it just feels that this evening is going to be a triumph.
So do I.
I had that trip to Vienna pegged correctly.
I don't remember the last time you had anything pegged correctly.
Erica, behold, that is one happy couple.
Oh, please.
Where do you think you're going?
I am going to prove you're wrong. That's where I'm supposed to stand.
Erica, I warned you not to make a spectacle of yourself chasing after that egomaniac.
And I have warned you not to give me any orders. Adam!
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Now that most everyone is here, I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you to my home and to thank you all for coming tonight. Now, the weather hasn't fully cooperated, but I'm sure that will keep you well fed and sheltered from the elements. Thank you. This is a very special night for me. As most of you know, I have been absent from this area for many years, and the purpose of tonight's ball is twofold. One is to let you know that I am back to stay. And two, to show off my lovely fiance. As you all know, she is the reason for my indescribable happiness. Natalie, you are my heart and soul, the light of my life.
I may gag.
And may tonight be but one of many magical moments for us.
How to waltz, have you?
My arms are weak.
It means a lot. Yeah, that you would go to bat for me with the warden.
It's no big deal.
Oh, it is. An immense deal. Oh, you have no idea how much better my life is because of you. I'm sure that sounds a little weird, but you know, when I was first sentenced to prison, I thought life was over. Yeah. And now, here I am, pregnant with our child, knowing that you care about me and you're willing to see.